The following program is intended for mature audiences.
Questions one might wish to answer by such studies should include: how might such information, under what circumstances, be presented to or withheld from the public? For what end? And then one might the role of the discovering scientist, Mad Martian, and other decision makers regarding release of the fact of discovery.
UFO diaries.
Faces on Mars.
Cover-up controversy.
Down
through time.
What happened was I wound up setting up Mad Martian. For what ends?
Gary Legere,
the Mad Martian, and I felt the need to give you an update on everything that's going on lately with regard to Arpel. Now, many of you know that Arpel is no longer doing this show, Midnight in the Desert, and he hasn't been on the show since. And since he left the show last, this is the first time that he has come out speaking about anything, really, publicly, regarding him, his show, or in other things, over the Dark Matter Radio Network fiascos and controversies and conspiracies with all that. Now, he was on this this podcast-type program called Gabcast or something for the Bell Gab Forum or some the place in a forum which deals and discusses about a show that really no longer exists. Again, connecting to Arpel, I took opportunity to decide, well, why not? He hasn't been out since this fiasco going on with Dark Matter Radio Network and with the Golden Carrot being offered to Mike Vara of Late Night in the Midlands to give Dark Matter Radio Network / Arpel power and control of L&M Radio Network, as well as Late Night in the Midlands, as well as all his archives. They were offering him a spot previous to Arpel's time that he would come on earlier, have a three-hour show. And like I said, it's a golden carrot. They were offering him a spot to which, you know, could have increased his career as it was. At least that was part of the golden carrot promise being offered to Mike. Mike was smart. He didn't give into it. He seen through their bullshit of what they were trying to do because focus was given to Michael for a decision that if he wants his show in that spot and for the opportunity, which they rubbed up against Mike trying to suggest, hey, it's an opportunity of a lifetime. But again, Mike saw through the bullshit and he denied them. And Mike exposed the fact that Richard Hoagland, with his show on Dark Matter Radio Network, The Other Side of Midnight, which means dawn, everybody, dawn of a new day, speaking code even in that show. Even the Dark Matter Radio Network itself is code connected to Hoagland. Dark matter, dark mission. It all goes together. Okay? It's not a coincidence. It's all code and it's all a fiasco, really. And the fact that Mike was offered a golden carrot, but he had to make the decision. The decision, what was that? Well, again, for those that don't know or that those that may know, let's reflect. Well, it was a decision he had to make about, quote, stop acquaintance / any relationships with Gary Legere and Mars Reveal at a Mad Martian. Strip me from Michael's archives, I'm sure, which Dark Matter Radio Network offered Mike to move all his archives over there. But it turned out that Richard C. Hoagland was behind, again, the conspiracy to try to lure Mike into that with that golden carrot into that network as long as he would drop me and drop the facts of the fact that Mike Vara, Late Night in the Midlands, also wanted to know the truth based upon the evidences and things that I had to say about Richard Hoagland and his connections to a video released in 93, though not in America, called UFO Diaries, Cydonia. Richard has been avoiding this, as many of you know, from even discussing it. Shit, I'm surprised he even mentioned the name UFO Diaries when he was on with a caller on his own show who was asking about UFO Diaries. That's the only time I ever heard him say in all these years, UFO Diaries.
Yeah, UFO Diaries.
So something has changed a little, but the fact of the matter, he's still avoiding answering anything about it. He doesn't want to answer about it. He calls you one of those people if you call in and ask him about it. Or he'll give you a long, meandering, bullshit answer, telling you untrue things of other things from his past, trying to meander the answer to explain about UFO Diaries, at least to the people who call in and ask him about it. And he just lies. He doesn't even tell you about UFO Diaries. He steers it to where you're confused. And if you know nothing of this case, and you think Hoagland is such a great guy, he's a famous person, blah, 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 he wouldn't lie to us. Bullshit. Okay, because The fact of the matter is he doesn't want to answer anything about it or answer or address the facts of the issues seen in that video, which was old, yet new image data showing other faces of Mars that NASA, over previous years, Viking era, anyway, imagery, which was from 76 to the early 80s, at least publicly until the mission ended. And that was the best data at that time available for when UFO Diaries was made, of which Richard Hoagland presented those images, according to the producers.
The fascination of the faces on Mars for me and my fascination with Richard Hoagland, who's been the big mover and shaker in all of that.
But Richard Hoagland, on the surface, encouraged me to investigate, and to everyone, which I have the evidence of, which he culled from his Enterprise Mission Conference Center subjects, for this, he erased all of it, but I saved it. And he says that he had no memory of the video, no memory of who the producers were, how to get in touch with them after all that time. It was an obvious lie.
The fascination of the faces on Mars for me and my fascination with Richard Hoagland, who's been the big mover and shaker in all of that.
But then I didn't know, you know, this was 2006, a June. But anyway, from the beginning in 2006, Hoagland was even avoiding answering about it then. So he said, requested me to, you know, do the serious legwork. He was too busy, you know, he was too swamped at present. Why? Because maybe the subjects ran him off the road, as it was metaphorically, into a swamp, into a bog. He's bogged down. He didn't want to answer it. And, you know, he wanted other people to do the work to find out who the producers were. So I did that. And I also did more. I had them on my show. They testified that Hoagland provided the images. What?
The fascination of the faces on Mars for me and my fascination with Richard Hoagland, who's been the big mover and shaker in all of that.
Yes, he provided the images, and he never addressed them for all those months in time. I waited a year for him to answer about those images. I waited a year also to get him on the air with the producers, which I did five times. We were set up, even with Richard, and then when I called Richard, he would either pick up or he would have some excuse he couldn't come on. Then why set up the shows to begin with? You know, there's a lot of things that are about this conspiracy of his, which the fact of the matter is that this guy everyone looks to, including myself back then.
The fascination of the faces on Mars for me and my fascination with Richard Hoagland, who's been the big mover and shaker in all of that.
I mean, it was a shock to me too. But he didn't want to answer it. And then he started punishing me for it because I kept, and I decided to keep on looking into the investigation. He originally said to everyone and encouraged me as well to investigate. It led to him. Therefore, he started punishing me over it, you know, wanting to offer me bribes, you know, offering me even a job, a paid job, even though I had a job already as an honorary member of the Enterprise mission for several years before I even brought this subject up. He's been an avid guest on my radio show, The Martian Revelation, which cometh again, I hope, this year, knock on wood. I'm, you know, got things going. Everything's got to go in order. So let's just say he wound up making me homeless. He tried to have me committed by his doctor, Robin, there, who pretended to be my doctor, to a doctor. I was at a hospital trying to get a checkup. And they talked to the doctor and basically told them that she was my doctor and that I needed help and tried to lock me out. This story's out there. The point of the matter is here that since 2006 of June until we had our final falling out in 2007 after he tried to have me committed and I couldn't take it anymore of his lies and deception, he crossed the line. He did a lot of things I'm not even mentioning. Again, it's out there on the record on Late Night in the Midlands with Mike Vara, even one episode show with Francis Walsh, who I hope was still going to continue to investigate to have me on again and look into this further, as he also said. But so far, I haven't heard anything. Maybe Richard got to him, or maybe he just feels he might not know enough to be able to tread upon these waters, or I don't know. But Francis didn't take me as a guy that would shy away from controversy. But whatever his reasons are, they are. But others have. That's the thing. Like Mike Vara of Late Night in the Midlands, as well as Michael of End of Days Radio. And his compadre Daniel there. Now, there were other shows I have been on, but none have been so outright spoken and wanting answers as Mike Vara and Mike of End of Days Radio. Now, a lot could be said there, too. But I don't want to take all the time because I want to get into about, again, or Wednesday, February 4th, 2016. Art Bell was on that Gabcast, whatever. He worships Art Bell. And everything's Art Bell. Art Bell this, Art Bell that. When Art left Coast, you know, it was still Art, you know, they were still focusing on Art Bell for years. And yeah, well, Art Bell was a great talk show host, and he paved the way in his fields of talk radio, as well as the genre of the subjects that get discussed on talk radio. Now there's multiples. But when they come across someone and something as famous as Art Bell, as well as Richard Hoagland, come forth with information from someone or some other sources or whatever, that there might be more to these two guys than meets the eye here, or something that challenges their beliefs because they want to have wholehearted faith in these people and because of how they thought they know them, because how they portrayed themselves to all the masses over the years of who they really are. Because now, down through time, it shows that who they really are is not who they are at all, but they're still trying to capture the moment in all your minds of that history of who they were. Because who they were is not who they are now, because of everything that's been going on, and especially regards to this controversy and conspiracy of Richard Hoagland regarding the UFO diaries, Faces of Mars images, and the complicity by Art Bell supporting Richard Hoagland's cover-up of that, thus also causing me harm, as well as George Norrie, for certain, that have caused me harm to where they both know who I am. They've both talked to me in the past, even previous to me bringing this case forth, and they still decide to suppress this issue because it puts Hoagland in a bad light. Therefore, it would put Art Bell in a bad light, because of the fact that Art Bell had a decision to make and he chose a side. A decision to make if he would still be true to himself, even though he was not on the air. I contacted him in 2012. Again, he knew me from previous years. I refreshed his memory in these emails of who I am. And, you know, he knows who I am. And for him not to reply and then defriend me over a year of being friends on Facebook, probably him seeing all my stuff I've been putting out on Hoagland, he was never replying to me. Then he unfriended me. At that point, I knew he was talking to Hoagland, and Hoagland must have gave him some type of story. At least on the surface, that's how one would interpret it. And therefore, instead of deciding to help me, to help us all get to the truth, because Richard Hoagland and Art Bell had a history, past history together, quote-unquote, being friends. Just like George Norrie was Hoagland's quote-unquote friend. Hoagland has a lot of quote-unquote friends, don't he? But a lot of these so-called quote-unquote friends usually don't share the same feelings. But let's just, you know, go in the direction of where I wanted to go with this. Because it's important that you all know and that you all see the endeavors being made by myself. Not that I'm a great guy or anything, and a lot of you, you know, have your various opinions, and I don't give a shit. Because what counts here is the fact of the facts of the matter of the subject at hand. An investigation that demands investigation, that demands questions to be answered, and none of them are wanting to answer it, but yet these are the people that people look to bring them answers regards to these type of subjects. Especially when one of them is deeply involved in the subject matter to begin with, who needs to answer things, and he's not, and we're finding complicity amongst other radio show hosts or other forums or venues, even though they all claim that they're truth seekers, they're looking for whistleblowers, and they bring forth the truth. Bullshit. Because then why do they shy away from this subject? Why? Because they don't like me? This is important enough. It's not like, you know, this is based on imaginary things. This is based on hardcore facts and hardcore evidence and hardcore science. And that's what counts here. And in science, you have to have an investigation and to be able to study the material of research. No? But it is. Hoagland taught me that. And to investigate no matter where it goes or no matter who it leads to. So, Art Bell was on the air on Wednesday, on February 4th. On this again, on this Gabcast, whatever you want to call it, Bell Gab podcast, whatever it was. Again, no one really knows of it. I'm not familiar with it. The show sucks anyway. The host incredibly sucks. He's not only rude, but his nose is so far up Art Bell's ass, I could smell the fumes myself. And this guy was really trying too hard, and it seemed like he was more happy and all giddy, like he finally got to have his idol, Art Bell, on. Well, after all these years, Art Bell finally, he's talking to him. He gets to have him on. Well, I said, okay, well, you know what's wrong with this picture? Me. Because I'm not going to let him get away with being on there after what he did to Mike Vara and what he helped expose and what they're running from. And what they did to me on my own Facebook page, because on my Facebook page, I put up a post where Art Bell said there were things that he would wish he could talk about, but he can't. And then that there were people out there he was calling trolls, obviously representative of an upset but hurt about what Mike Vara did, and exposed him on his own network before they threw him off, cut him off and threw him off. But Mike Vara had it pre-recorded. So he had his ducks lined up in a row because he expected that. I had no idea what Mike was doing. He just said, Gary, you might want to listen to them tonight for when that Mike Vara did that. So I did. And I was blown away. I was blown away because I didn't expect him to go where he was going. I didn't even know what he was going to say. But he exposed Art Bell. He exposed Richard Hoagland as being a controlling handler of Dark Matter Radio Network because of what they tried to do to Mike and his radio network and his show, to offer him the golden carrot to drop me, as long as he dropped me, and obviously drop this subject, because Mike wants to know the truth of UFO Diaries in his faces also. Plus, he's pissed at what they did to me. And what they did to him showed him all the more the potential reality for an individual to see how Richard Hoagland or anyone could have any such power to destroy a person's radio show or to do things in secret to try to destroy that person's life in order to get them to shut up about something if they didn't want to. They think they're above it all. They think they're above you all, claiming hardship and poor, being poor. And Mike exposed them too. They're pulling in damn over $100,000. I mean, give me a break. And Hoagland getting a big percentage of that, and Art Bell getting the most. So Art Bell came up with this big story all of a sudden to drop everything, to get off the air, his family's being threatened, whatnot. We all think it's a publicity stunt, and maybe not. And if it's, you know, and if it's not, well, I'm sorry. But then he's a pussy, because he's stopping his show. Something for millions of people were waiting for him for years to wonder if he'd ever come back. He comes back, sets everyone up, the Dark Matter Radio Network. Hoagland is in the midst, having a deciding factor through emails, thanks to Keith Rowland. Okay, another guy that's been used by them over the years. Okay, Rowland's not new to this game. He knows who I am also very well as what the case Mike Vara tried to show Keith Rowland what this was about, because Keith Rowland decided, no, now I'm in the middle of it. So, yeah. He has to be in the middle of it. So Mike Vara politely said, hey, I seen the evidences, you know, I've seen the stuff that Gary had to say. So basically, Richard was the decide. Well, if you're going to do that, then you can't be on, because, you know, you're just helping Mad Marsh and Gary Legere attack Richard. Like Richard's the fucking victim, when it was me who was the victim, and it was Mike who was the potential victim there, and you are all the victims. Why? Because this controversy is to keep this subject under a rug and away from you all. So you're all, whoever's fans of his and paying them, you're going there and paying them for what? To give you lies? To steer you into a false direction and a false truth, when the truth, when it's confronted to their faces, when they're in part of the very subject at hand that demands answers from these people? And you're okay with that? Just because you think they're so famous, they're so great? They're not that famous. What's so good about them? Art's been gone for a long time. He comes back, misleads everybody, admits he's burned bridges everywhere. He burned bridges with you all more than any type of radio show network or anything. But he also burned bridges regards to his own network and the other shows on there. Okay? Giving these other radio shows hope and feeling positive because they and happy that they're a part of the Art Bell network and Art Bell's back. They're all being noticed by Art Bell and Art Bell's audience. Therefore, everyone has something to benefit. And then Art Bell all of a sudden jut out of the game. Why? Something's going on. And the fact of the matter is that regardless whatever Art Bell's situation is, what he decided to do, thanks to Mike Vara, he shows complicitness. Therefore, it shows that Art Bell's causing me harm too, and Art Bell doesn't even have to say nothing about me. He knows who I am. He knows the many emails I've sent to him begging him, yes, begging him to help me. He, by his calm voice and his extra savoir-faire, he, being the relationship we had with Hoagland over all the many years, that he would be the one that could help bring this story about and ask Hoagland about it and whatnot. No, or have me on to talk about it to find out. First, to give it to the audience to hear. You would think that's his job. He claims that's his job. He, you know, to bring people forth that want to have things to reveal, to expose to the public. He says, yes, I love doing that, do you? Then why are you causing me harm, Art? And you're doing that. You're causing me harm by showing complicitness. Therefore, you're aiding and abetting a criminal, basically, who did criminal acts unto me. And he's crying like he's the victim. That's bullshit. And that's bullshit on you, Art Bell. All right? And that's wrong of you. As the show host who you want people to think that you were, that you still are, and you're not. You fucked everybody over. And people still want to follow you. Why am I deciding to do this now? Well, because I heard things. And once Mike Vara confirmed that for me, on the record now, it just proves some of those things of which I've heard, you know, through the bite waves and little birdies out there, you know? So, about what their agenda is regards to me, that I was a big part of their discussions on what is to be done and what will be done with me, and especially by them having their own radio shows, how they will encounter when I encounter them and vice versa, how I will be handled. This was already laid out and planned even when Hoagland started his show. Yes. Again, look at the evidence Mike Vara shows. They're from last year. Around September. This is not new information. It's new to everybody else. This carrot deal has been dangling in front of Mike, and the pressure that must have been on him is astounding. But he's still seen through it. He was soul searching. And he knows who he is. He knows what the right thing to do was. Now Mike Vara might have thought, well, oh my God, this would really get Gary going, you know, and, you know, who knows? Who knows who he taught? And that's his business, you know, but he would be right there. He showed me something that night to where he has heart and he has true spirit of a true radio host. And because of the guy who was interviewing Art Bell, I had to call in. I had to make my presence felt, mainly because there would be might be my only opportunity since Bell never replied back. I'm going to play the clips from that night, from Wednesday, February 4th. On my attempt to get in touch and to butt horns with him, to confront him openly about this.
Faces on Mars.
Cover-up controversy.
Down
through time.
Because it might be my only chance on the air. You understand? And this host, MV or whoever the hell he is, who had his nose so far up Bell's ass again, I smelt the fumes myself. It was disgusting. He's an ass-kisser and a worshiper and does not let anything come to Art that may threaten what he was trying to do with Art on that show. Again, he was ass-kissing and he was all in his giddies because he had his idol hero on there. Again, Art Bell was a great host. Was. He's screwing everyone over left and right and he's still doing it and he's screwing me over. So you're damn right I called in. I had to confront him. I want an answer. Why did Art Bell side with Hoagland about this? I'm sure he talked to Hoagland about it. I'm sure they're connected together. on this controversy and conspiracy of this acclimation program, again, I say, is based on Brookings, and everything they're doing is only on the surface sideshow bullshit, because it's a distraction to cause confusion to you people so you won't know who to trust, because one side wants the truth out and one side does not. Again, that's a subject where I've talked about it on other shows and you got to hear it, but it adds up. And so I had to take my opportunity to strike anytime and anywhere I can publicly to call these people out. I'm not even going to call them gentlemen because they're not. Okay, because Art Bell's complicitness, he's aiding and abetting a criminal and doing criminal acts, which the statutes of limitations are still open because Hoagland continues to do this. And now Art Bell has done this, and I'll play that evidence soon. Openly. He tried to backtrack from it, but then he slid right back into that base to where he said what he said, and there's no way around it. So, and instead of getting to the bottom of it, which Art Bell knows, he's basically wondering why I'm going after him now. Like, I'm going after him. No, I'm going after him in the sense I need answers. I need his help. We all do. Because with his help, we can help get the truth about these images, about that UFO diaries. And because we thought he was honest, he used to, at least on the surface over the many years, it looked like he used to put pressure on Richard C. Can you see it now, Hoagland, as Art Bell used to call him. So what the hell? What's wrong with this picture? Why doesn't he do this now for me or for anyone else just because it comes back to Richard? What happened, Mr. Bell? You used to challenge him, or at least that's how you used to make it appear. Great sideshow, huh? You bunch of fucking liars. You're all a sideshow. Acting. Theater. You're playing a part. But the thing is now, you're caught in the middle because you chose to side with Hoagland. You chose the dark side. You guys created Dark Matter Radio Network. You know, he's on his dark mission. And now, well, am I crazy? Well, Mike Vara shows the proof. Hoagland's the deciding factor, not Art Bell, of what Michael's radio show could be on or not. Who the hell is Hoagland to do that to anybody? Or to say anything. He's lucky to have his show on there. On the surface, it was Art Bell that gave him that spot just to see where Richard could go. Bullshit. They're a part of the same dark mission team behind the scenes. Bell's a Mason, as well as Hoagland. They're on the same team. Bell had a job to do, just like Hoagland has a job to do, and he fulfilled it. He created the environment for Richard to continue his dark mission. But yet, at the same time, it's for a purpose. To point you all to what this game changer, to change the game, is to show you all to change your consciousness so it can clearly be seen Richard's right. The good are getting better, the bad are getting worse. Me and Mike Vara and others who are wanting to know the truth are the good. We're getting better. Why? Because we're not seeing that bullshit. We're continuing on with this investigation, trudgingly along, wanting answers, wanting the truth, wanting these images. So we could really start the damn investigation instead of having an investigation into the Twilight Zone and, you know, and some kind of code of Hoagland's based on Brookings as an acclimation program to bring us the truth down through time, because officially no one could talk about it. Everyone's officialed up the ass, but unofficially, I have a working mechanism and a working model. But on the surface, they can't acknowledge it. In fact, on the surface, their job is to try to destroy it, destroy those who persist into trying to find out about it, no matter who it is. They tried to pull that crap with Michael, and I think that helped Mike see the light more about the reality and the fact and the truth and the evidences of what I presented and what I testified about regards to what Hoagland did to me, my family, and my radio show. Because I wouldn't shut up and I wouldn't stop the investigation. How do you stop an investigation with people like this that want to know the truth about something, especially when they have a radio show? Why? Because that's the biggest weapon. The greatest threat to them is their radio shows. So they wanted to snag Mike in the noose, lure him in with the golden carrot, give him control of his radio network he was trying to create, give him control of his acts, of his archives, which Mike created and has available. But you have to also stop any relationship with Gary Legere, the Mad Martian. You cannot have him on. Therefore, my archives would not be in their network. Now, if Art Bell does not care about what Richard Hoagland says or is doing, why does he leave it up to Richard Hoagland as a deciding factor, like Art Bell's his little bitch? Something's wrong there. I thought it was Art Bell's network, not Richard's. So why is Richard, again, having a deciding factor? Now, I know I sound kind of repetitious, but that's okay.
Science is about repeatability. Science is about repeatability. Science is about repeatability. Isn't it, Hoagland? Those are your words.
Down through time being thrown back in your mouth. I mean, I'm not saying anything, again, that you would disagree with. Like Lee Eric Shackelford said. Because you were scripted into something and you basically didn't want to say what was scripted for you. So they took they scripted you in using your own words, putting them back in your mouth with a code. So down through time, you're discovered. Get it? Because you were undercover. Now your cover's broken. Your shield that protects you, which is your script, it can't protect you no more because we're inside the crack, and I'm trying to help people in, change their consciousness so we can see what you're doing.
And we can see who you really are and what you're really doing.
And like you said, on Gaiam, once we see this and our consciousness has changed, then, like you said, the people cannot just sit there and listen to you and believe you. In fact, they should not. And I find that kind of funny, and it is hilarious once we see it. And thus, yeah, you're kicking your own ass because I got you explaining it, just like they did. So, isn't it ironic or a coincidence that I'm such a big threat to you? Again, who am I? You like to say how famous you are and everything, but yet, lowly little old crazy me, according to you, is a big problem to you amongst you and other radio networks, to where you gotta focus on me. Give so much attention to me that you gotta have a controversy, a conspiracy amongst all your little minions. Hey, don't talk to that Mad Martian. Believe my lies. Here's a little bit of piece of the truth. But I can't tell you more, but you're already in bed with me. So I can hook you up with this. I can hook you up with that. Let's create something special together. We all make money. That's all you care about. You don't care about the truth. If you did, and especially you, Art Bell, I'm ashamed at you, and you should be shamed. And you know what? You deserve to have whatever happened to you. Couldn't have happened to a better guy. Doing that to everyone, doing that to the audience, misleading the masses. Who the hell are you to do that? Think about this. Who were you? That's what you need to think about. Who were you? You still have opportunity to answer. You still have opportunity to do the right thing and stand up and have balls and be who you were and what you wanted everyone to think that you were over the years. Because this conspiracy breaks all that wide open and exposes you, exposes Hoagland, and exposes all the frauds that help support you. So when this is found out and all the evidence given and all the truth is finally made known, all you and your little minions are going to be gone. Your audiences are going to leave you. And who are they going to go to? Then they're going to gravitate to another direction, to those who wanted the truth and were trying to bring the truth to everyone else. Because you guys are exposed as the liars and the frauds, and as well as ripping everyone off of their money. That's all you care about. And I also decided to do this because I heard a lot of people in that Bell Gab and other places. Even I heard that there's sources that have sources to the inside of Dark Matter Radio Network itself, amongst Hoagland and Bell and Rogland, that they are very pissed at me for what I did. Why? Because I called in, I had balls, and I put them on the spot, and I let a lot of people know the name UFO Diaries, the fact, the faces of Mars, the controversy, Richard Hoagland and his conspiracy and his suppression of the truth of these images and the subject of a video he was fucking in himself. He was in more than a third of that video, but yet he doesn't want to talk about it. Art Bell doesn't want to ask him about it. Art Bell didn't see these faces, images. Bullshit, he's seen them. And anyone else in their right mind, I guarantee you all, if Richard Hoagland was not involved in this video, Richard would have been at the forefront jumping at the subject because it would bring him more money. It would bring him more conference attendees to make money and to show you all some pretty cool stuff. Oh, the faces of Mars. Come on, any Mars anomalous out there should glob onto that. And it's like, damn, finding something literally that was never meant to be found. At least by the intelligence guys. Richard is part of them. Again, this is all based on a Brookings plan of acclimation to not freak everybody out, to get everyone used to the idea, to make it safe to be seen, because everyone's officialed up the ass. They can't talk about it. So once it's safe to be seen, then he could come out and acknowledge it himself. But all the minions who bought it, all right, I won't talk, but I want a little bit of piece of the truth. He'll give it. But you can't say nothing. And you know, maybe he has them sign contracts. I don't know. But none of them pursued the truth of the answers, even though all these minions and all these networks, their audiences want the truth. They want to hear me on the air. They want to see the evidence. They want to hear my story, but I keep getting hung up on. I keep getting slandered, attacked, and no focus is ever going into that video. Isn't that interesting? It's only a 22-minute long fucking video. What is the problem? It's only a documentary, cheesily made, some would say. Is it? Is it? Watch it. Because that's the source of the conspiracy. That's the source of the cover-up. That's the source of the disclosure. Right. And the discovering. Discovering. We're discovering what was covered. And discovering someone who worked undercover. What happens in an intelligence world? You know, if you become found out, you're discovered. Wink, wink. It's hard for you to even be an operative anymore, a functional one. He's outed. But he's trying to keep on his persona to keep milking the public for money and a prestige of what he once had, but he still wants to continue to have, thinking that he beat me, thinking that he beat all of you, thinking that he's smarter than all of you, that you're all too stupid, and those are his words, that you're all too stupid, that all the evidence is out there, so once NASA is found out lying, NASA could just say, no, look, it's all out there all along. It's not my fault you people are too stupid. You couldn't see it. So what am I referring? What is Hoagland referring? In this code, Hoagland is NASA.
So when I say NASA, I want to be very clear.
I'm NASA and you're not?
NASA's coding things to you, knowing that you all are too stupid or too blind or not enough balls to even ask them about it or pursue it if you would have seen it. Now, if Hoagland wasn't involved in this, all of you people, too, would have been on the me like glue to find out the truth about these other faces of Mars. Really? They're not in any NASA public archive, especially for Viking. It took me a year and a half, literally, in the outset of the years of my start of this investigation to do the best sensible thing. Process every single publicly given Viking raw image data available. They never put out the processed versions of their imagery for some reason with Viking. It's in the raw format. And any that they did give out, it was always shitty processed. Thus, your little dots around the Cydonia face, the famous face of Mars picture from 76, all grainy. I mean, come on, it's been rightly processed to where you could see the crisp, clear details, and it looks like a face. But no, that's the policy-driven face to try to keep a mockery of it because no one's allowed to talk about it. And that, again, I've talked about that on other shows, but that goes into hours of other discussion of why that policy is in place. Why all the hit pieces over the years of the face of Mars being a mere trick, a light and shadow. And that's code too, a trick of light and shadow, light and dark. You get it? Dark mission, dark matter. They go hand in hand, okay? Richard Hoagland said, oh, I'm a misguided missile that was fired off by the dark side, by the bad guys.
And I have the awful feeling that Gary has been turned into a kind of misguided missile by the dark side, by the bad guys. Because in an era where there is a changing physics, so more people are conscious, more people are looking around and saying, what the hell am I doing? Why is that happening? That doesn't make sense. We need to change that. When that is a general societal occurrence, it means you can no longer keep secrets. In that era, the only way you can keep secrets is to try to confuse people, to just screw things up so that no one knows who to trust. And so I view Gary as a someone who is predisposed to be susceptible to influences where he becomes a disinfo agent by the dark side, by the bad guys, to basically screw up data that we're trying to present in a logical, coherent, scientific fashion.
Really? And to hear people chuckling and laughing, but yet they didn't know what the fuck he was talking about. They're confused. What is he talking about? That doesn't make sense. We need to change that, Hoagland says. Yes, so it does make sense. And I changed the script to help it make sense to you all. So you who have seen him say those things, now it makes sense because you have something to connect it to because he's talking in code.
The politics, who did what to whom, what the timelines are, what may be happening day after tomorrow, what's going on in Washington, it's all a set of scenarios prescinding from this database that I've spent 30-plus years trying to figure out. So no, you don't make me upset by asking the question. You make me sad because we really tried to help someone. And as they say, no good deed goes unpunished. The good news is, by Gary doing what he's doing, he's forcing more people to ask deeper and better questions like you, allowing me the opportunity to set the record straight. I don't normally take out after people. If you've noticed over the last several decades, I don't say bad things about most people. In fact, extraordinarily rarely do I come out and call a certain individual by name in certain ways that do not seem to accord with our objective, which is to figure out what the hell is going on and get the truth. This is delicate to talk about because the individual who is promulgating this is not totally here, and I don't mean that in a positive sense. He calls himself Mad Martian, and unfortunately that is somewhat accurate. In fact, extraordinarily rarely do I come out and call a certain individual by name in certain ways that do not seem to accord with our objective, which is to figure out what the hell is going on and get the truth. When this phenomenon first surfaced, it was so obvious to me, based on information that I don't really have time to go into. I mean, I could, but it would take too much time.
I'm going to ask for more than one person to reply to the same question. Go right ahead.
Okay. That it was obvious to me that this new wave of, shall we say, reportage was part of a very sophisticated campaign to do what I just described. In an era of rising physics and rising consciousness, where even the mainstream is commenting on certain phenomena that they can't understand why people are changing their minds so rapidly. And they keep commenting over and over again, this is happening at an incredible pace, and you're seeing politicians every day step to a microphone and suddenly change their position. In that era, you really can't keep secrets much longer. So the only defense mechanism of the bad guys, the controllers, the ones that want to keep us down on the farm,
I'm NASA and you're not?
is to spread confusion and dissension and information that can't be checked but comes with an exquisite, believable storyline, which in a way is a kind of a metaphysical test. It's like, where is your internal discernment? What do you resonate with? What do you feel is the truth as opposed to what at the moment you can actually prove? I view, admittedly, in a very jaundiced light, in view of the data we have looked at,
the faces on Mars,
and the fact that we really shouldn't have this data at all. We should have, if the control of the real solar system and our real heritage and who we really are was 100% absolute, we wouldn't even be having this conference. We wouldn't know anything was wrong. So again, the fact of this phenomenology suddenly springing up about a couple of years ago, to me, is an indicator that we're winning. The other side, the dark side, by the bad guys.
the other side of midnight
is getting so desperate to try to maintain control that their last avenue of control is to confuse people. So the folks that are trying to do things, Mad Martian, Gary, that's his real name, Gary Legere, are viewed with suspicion and fear as opposed to an open, okay, let's see where this goes.
I mean, I've spent my life on world mysteries, so I'm willing to investigate this further and see what we can find.
Fear is the mechanism. So I view this area, particularly the involvement of certain very visible high-level political persons, as a mechanism of distraction from the agenda of where we seem.
The other side of midnight.
In resonance with this wave, this surfs up physics, which we're all riding toward an extraordinarily different future, if I read the numbers correct. And it's almost, again, sad that this is happening because it's not going to work. It's not going to distract us very long. It doesn't need to have names attached to it. It will fall by the wayside. And the reality of the extraordinary past and future we once had and can have again will come to the fore.
Okay, thank you.
Let me add one postscript.
Ask lots of questions.
Okay. We have documented in Dark Mission that all of the astronauts, except for one, appear to have been subject to, and I'll use a gentle term here, mind alteration. The one guy who wasn't, who was held as sacred among that group, unfortunately is now no longer with us. He also is the one astronaut who never appeared in public, except under extraordinarily rare circumstances. And when he did, he was very, very taciturn and very circumspect in what he said, except on the 25th anniversary of Apollo at the White House, with the President of the United States standing behind him, where he spoke in such a blatant code about what Apollo really did and what it accomplished and what it brought home, that even some skeptics I know were raising their eyebrows. Because he started out that speech by referring and comparing the astronauts to parrots who couldn't fly very well. And what are parrots known for besides flying? Repeating things they've been told.
I'm NASA and you're not?
So he tried to tell the truth, and in Emily's parlance, to tell it slant. I feel this current group of individuals, because I pay very close attention, as one has to when you're trying to mix the politics and the science and thread your way through the matrix, I feel this current group of individuals is equally sincere and also have had their minds altered, that they have a script and they believe their script. It doesn't mean we have to.
Believe it or not.
Motherfuckers!
So if there is, in fact, a code, number one, and if there are, in fact, photos that we have that no one else ever had,
right?
We just gathered all the stuff from all the normal sources. We got them from Hoagland, we got them from NASA, and there you are. I mean, one of them's going to say, yeah, those are ours.
Well, I would love if I could get these images in my hands personally.
Let's continue to pursue this a little further, though, because...
Okay, I'm all over to that.
I'm headed somewhere with this. It's all of the different predictions from just about every
UFO diaries.
Culture, and try to make some sense of it and put it all together into an end-time scenario of what the picture is being painted that's going to happen.
This is all about some goofy code of disclosure to make things safe to be seen because no one could talk about it safely until it's time.
And I know this might sound a little nuts, sir.
No, it doesn't, because I have a possible answer. Let me, again, give you the three possibilities with this.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, we filmed this in a Masonic lodge. Oh, Masonic Lodge built in the 1800s. Okay? It was a very weird place, and that's why we filmed there, you know?
Okay.
And I have always had strong feelings that these Masonic Lodges knew something and were passing on something, you know, down through time that we needed to know. But what that said to me is that there are things that we need to know. Lee Shackelford.
You know, it's exactly that kind of thing that had really started to convince me that some of the conspiracy and cover-up stories that we were doing on the show actually had more meat to them than I thought they did.
Yes.
Accessing data. Affirmative.
But, you know, you put your finger right on it. Those are the things that have always interested him. What's going on behind the surface of the things that we can see? You know, those are the stories that he's always been interested in telling. And so UFO Diaries was a real natural.
So, obviously, my part in this has been being the one who's been afflicted and affected and victimized and having to continue to investigate because of those facts. And I cannot let up or give up because I want who I am back, as well as what I wanted to do back, as well as what I was trying to do back, whether I fail or succeed on my own volition. Not by some Dick Hoagland's meandering and his operativeness behind the scenes of trying to destroy me, destroy my life, destroy my family, and also other people's radio shows who I consider brothers to me. Mike Vara proved himself to be a brother, not just a friend. He's a brother because he had the balls and put his career on the line to back me. Why? Because he's seen the evidence. He sees through the bullshit. He sees what they were trying to do to him. It's following. Come on. You know, it doesn't become illusion anymore or coincidence once it keeps getting lighter from their darkness. It's getting darker and lighter. The good are getting better. The bad are getting worse. That's what it means. They're the bad guys because they're the dark missioners. Therefore, they're the dark side, of course.
By the dark side, by the bad guys.
They have to be destroyed. So therefore, they're the bad. And they are getting worse because look what they've been doing. Has it not been following Richard Hoagland's model? Even in code and on the surface, and the good are getting better. Who, me, Mike, and others? Because look where we're at. And we're getting better at confronting them. We're getting better at getting the masses to know about this.
Faces on Mars.
Cover-up controversy.
Down
through time.
And to confront Arpel and Richard Hoagland. They're birds of feather. Prove me wrong, Art. Richard, you already proved yourself as suspect. You're just trying to imagine and make people like this doesn't exist. You know, like you close your eyes, no one will see you, but yet everyone's seeing you. And that's how you live. And that's how you keep acting. And then you keep saying things. Yes, yes. You know, this is my show.
The Other Side of Midnight.
You know, where we look for the truth. Call and talk about whatever it is on your mind, but don't talk about UFO Diaries. You don't do UFOs. You tried to make a cover, because I've been saying for years that when you say that, you really mean you don't do UFO Diaries. And then when you're confronted with that, you had to try to change and make up a reason why you don't talk about UFOs, and it still didn't even make sense in your fucking answer to people of why you don't do UFOs, except for my explanation. You don't do UFOs because you can't do them because you're in the UFO Diaries, and that's what exposes you and what destroys you. It's not my fault. You tried to destroy me, therefore I gotta now do what needs to be done because you've proven by your actions, never mind your lying words or half-truths, code or not, you are connected to something very real here. And by the testimony by the producers, what, they're the liars? You've yet to be on the air with me with them. One of them's dead now. And you like to say on your show to someone, oh, what about Chuck Sellier? Oh, you know, he's dead now, the guy said. And you said, oh, well, then no one, that's a shame because now no one could ask him about what he meant about anything. Bullshit. I asked him what he meant. I got what he meant.
We got them from Hoagland, we got them from NASA, and there you are. I mean, one of them's going to say, yeah, those are ours.
You just don't want to hear it, and you don't want to play it for people, and you don't want to allow anyone to bring it forth to you without you hanging up on them or calling them crazy or one of those people. You know, something you don't want acknowledged or to exist, you attribute it to a group of people? Therefore, when people hear it, they're like, wow, he attributes this to a group of people. That means, let's go see what this is about. Why, when you detracted some at the same time, you seem to be leading them, wanting to steer them to this group of people? That's one of those people. I mean, talk about crazy, and you say, I'm crazy? Look, I see through your bullshit. I see what's going on to some degree. I don't know the outcome of the ultimate plan of what it is you guys have or what it is I am in this for the future. But I know one thing. I ain't going to be punked by the likes of you scumbags. Yes, yeah, scumbags. Because that's what you are. And that's what you're doing continually to do regards to this subject that demands investigation, to which people have testified and are not being able to be heard. We're not, because of you, like you guys are above them. Mr. Sellier, Mr. Shackelford, Richard, you're beneath them. Prove me wrong. Who are you? They were big Hollywood heavy hitters. Why would they lie about you bringing the images? I don't know them. I didn't know them from Adam. Why would they just come on after many years of a video no one's ever seen, over 13 years till I released it, and they come on and lie about you, but you couldn't come on and spank them? I was on your side. Remember, I was like a son to you. But besides that being the case, I was a part of your team. I was your friend. I thought you were my friend. You told me, I'm your best friend. Are you? Best friends don't do the shit type of shit that you tried to do to me, and that you have done to me, and that you're still continuing to do to me, and getting people like Art Bell now to where I have to go after him, get people pissed off. I don't give a crap about if they're pissed off or not. Too bad. The facts are the fact that Art Bell's complicit to your conspiracy, and I had to call in that night, especially by the arrogance of that show host, with his nose so far implanted up Art Bell's ass. Again, I smelt the fumes myself. It's disgusting. And knowing that no truth was coming out of that, Art Bell was on there basically, I think, just to try to cover and make things good because of what Mike did to them and expose them. It shocked the shit out of them, and they did not expect. They really thought they could punk Mike easily. They know better now about thinking that they could punk me. They've tried over the years and used certain Project Scamalot minions to try to do so, even Project Scamalot themselves to do so, without, again, even having me on to talk about it. Isn't that interesting? And then have, like, case closed, that bitch Kerry Cassidy saying that I'm being hit by beam weapons, as that's what the explanation is of why I'm so angry and why this is coming out the way it is. No, she's a scam artist. They're in bed together, just like Hoagland was. Hoagland was with Nori. Now, notice that Scamalot hasn't done anything with Hoagland since. Why? But yet they haven't contacted me since. Why? Because she's exposed. And she could have redeemed herself by getting me on, because her audience also wanted to know the truth about this. Now, people listening to me now may say, oh, he's just ranting, really. But it's okay for those scumbags to rant, and you guys will hold on to every little word of the little hairs on their nuts like it's gold and like it's the gospel. Bullshit. And you guys are paying them for it. The subscriptions. Bullshit. So the game changer decided to call in and change the game. And I had it on the inside from people that, well, since I pissed many people off by my appearance on Wednesday night, continued appearance, because it wasn't just one call. It was several. You know, I wasn't going to give in to them because the people had to know about UFO Diaries. They had to know the Faces of Mars. They had to know Hoagland has a conspiracy and is suppressing a conspiracy about him and a suppression of these images, to which you would think he would be the guy, the first guy who would want to, for you, get the information of those images for you. No? Prove me wrong there and I'll stop investigating them and I'll apologize to everyone. Tell me he wouldn't be the guy he would have to go to. Especially, people, when you don't give a shit about my history with the, and connections with this guy. Okay? He encouraged investigation. He stalled me for a year, even with bribes and threats. Well, no, then it led to threats toward when we were breaking down, and then he tried to have me committed that week when the threats came of May of 2007. So a year later, I couldn't take it anymore. He wouldn't show up for the producers, and he helped set the shows up. So what? For what? Just to make me look stupid? So therefore, what? I'll feel embarrassed with the tail, run with the tail between my legs? Bullshit. I wanted the answers. And I know Mr. Cellier, Mr. Shackelford were telling the truth. Their points were consistent. And it was to the point on many things. And also coded. To which I had to come back like your words down through time and your past appearances on my show, Mr. Hoagland. I had to go back and listen to. Once I got the gist of this code better, I could see what was trying to be told to me and where I was being led. And thanks to all their clues and even yours, Dick, this is allowing me to come where I am now, to where I am such a threat that so important to you guys that you had to talk about crazy old me. Again, you want people to think I'm crazy. And that I'm such a big factor that all these radio shows have to ignore me if they want to stay connected to you. Well, you told Mike that the first time he ever contacted you about me. Hey, I got this crazy guy on. He wanted you on to spank me. But, you know, you said no. You said, well, who is it? He mentioned my name and nothing. Well, if you had, you know, Gary on your show, I'll never be on. Like, who the fuck are you? Mike's seen through your crap. He's like, well, I guess I'll have Gary on. You won't be on. But that don't mean he was going to stop trying to get answers. You thought you punked him. Art Bell, you thought you punked him. So why am I doing this? Why am I going to show you my call-ins to his only show to where I had to ruin it for that MV host of that Gabcast or whatever the fuck you want to call it, shitty-ass show, which I heard is always boring anyway. Like I told him, I'd never heard of it anyway. It's not like it's familiar to me. He's a nobody. He's trying to be somebody. He was very mad that Mike Vara got the spot, opportunity for the spot. He was mad and pissed that he didn't get the spot, and you know, Mike Vara has some things to say about that as well. Yeah, it continues. And because this is about justice. This is about truth. This is about what we deserve to know. We deserve to know if these guys are con artists, don't we? We deserve to know if these guys aren't true to who they really are claimed to be and yet want your money, do we? We have the truth to know about that UFO diaries, don't we? We have the truth to know about, definitely about those Faces of Mars images, don't we? And the guys that have the opportunity to make this happen for us have a conspiracy against all of us? And many people are okay with that. Then how and why? What are they in? Why are they worshiping these guys for then? Just because they like hearing them talk? Or was it based upon who they thought they were in this field of work? So, yes, I had the balls and the audacity to call into this prick's MV show. And that's what he is, a prick. What are you going to do about it, MV? Shut me up now. Hang up on me. Come sedate me, I dare you. You prick. The fact of the matter is this. There's a conspiracy underway against everybody, as I just said. They think they're above you all. They're snobby-nosed motherfuckers who are only lying to you to get your money. Every opportunity they turn around begging for your money, acting like they're broke, and that they need you in order to survive, they need your money. And that puts on a bad look and a bad face on those who really do need your money to support what they're really trying to bring you. And they're not trying to do to you. Remember, Hoagland and Bell are in this just for the money. Never mind the dark mission Masonic plan of Brookings Class Disclosure Acclimation Program that has to be revealed to us all. It's the process and the sideshow that leads us to there, but people's lives have been affected and almost killed over it. Mine, especially. Notice I said almost, Rich. I dare you to try it again. I'm not going nowhere. I told you this case ain't going nowhere. It's only getting stronger. You're not. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? You're going to hide under a rock forever? Hide from anyone? I even heard it from a good, valuable source, so I'll name nameless again. Not only was the insiders of Dark Matter Radio Network very pissed at me because of Wednesday, now they feel me as more of a threat to them because I helped Michael expose them because he has a show. What are you going to do when the Martian revelation comes back? Yeah, Rich, it's coming back. What are you going to do about it? I dare you. I dare you, Art. What are you going to do about it? How are you going to shut me up then? How are you going to shut me up from your audiences that are guaranteed going to hear of me, going to hear of that show, and are definitely going to hear about this case as a mascot as it was for the show? Until this animal gets collared. You understand my metaphor there? My little torsion throw at you? This has got to stop. And that's why I called in. I don't care who gets pissed off. The people should be pissed off at them. They're the ones being robbed. I'm not trying to win a fan base. I don't have my show on at the moment. I'm in a fight. So, of course, I sound as I sound. And people want to talk shit about that. But yet, they want to steer away from the facts and ask stupid questions. Not even a smart question about any subject. They'll ask him stupid questions just so he could speak and keep getting your money. And avoiding bringing you all the truth. So, is Art Bell and Richard Hoagland, in your mind, still the people who you think they really are? I mean, look, I had to interrupt someone else's show from him having his jollies that he got to have his boyhood idol on, his child idol. He acted like a child, his nose up his ass, asking stupid questions, soft questions, ridiculing and downing the callers that call in. He was very rude. This guy does not know how to be a show host. He's pretending to be. And yet he had the audacity and the balls to complain about Mike Vara being offered the spot over Howard Hughes of the Unexplained radio show. And that he wasn't chosen. Instead of Mike? Mike's got far more on you than you ever will as a show host, asshole. Yeah, I'm calling you an asshole. You see, I could do that. Prove me wrong. So let me play these clips. I don't want this thing to last forever, but let me play these clips of the many attempts of me trying to call in to confront Art Bell, where we block horns for a few seconds here and there. And it's even surprising that Art Bell actually wanted to have dialogue. So don't just think I'm attacking Bell. I'm going after him to help expose him in his complicitness to show you all to Hoagland's conspiracy he is with this, therefore causing me harm as a byproduct, but definitely as the added byproduct to all of you, because he's helping the suppression continue while Hoagland's in charge of that dark mission network. And that's what it should be called. Instead, no, he has to bite off Don Eckers' radio show name, Dark Matter Radio Network. Don Eckers' show has been around for how many years? Dark Matters Radio? And I've yet to be a guest on his show. I got questions for him as well. But I'm more respectful to him. And I know that he's more of a decent host and more of a honest host than you were, MV. Or you, Richard Hoagland. And obviously you, Art Bell. How dare you step on and bite off his name and claim it for your own. Like who you think you are? Hoagland tried to get Don Eckern to reach around and have him on his show. I asked Don to have me on his show. And Don said when his show came back on, when it was temporarily off, he will have me on. Well, his show's been back on. I haven't got a reply. I've been asking him since 2012 also. But I don't want to attack him. I like Don. And I think Don sees through a lot of bullshit. And if he had the opportunity to really feel me out here and hear my story and see the presentation and really look at this, I think he would clearly see what's going on here. And I don't think he would really be in disagreement. He's got more balls than any of yous. What happened to your balls, Art? All these people worship you for your past balls. What happened? So I want to show this clips from the other night at the absurdity and the disrespect of the show host to callers, not just myself, as well as even Art Bell, stepping over him even when Art wanted to communicate with me about this. Art seemed concerned and tolerable of what I'm sure he felt my position. But that show host didn't make it easy for him, and Art didn't stop him, that show host, again, from doing what he was trying to do to me just so that Art didn't have to answer to this. I could have sworn Art was getting frustrated with him a couple times, but again, that's me. What do I know, right? And you're going to be surprised because I also offered Art Bell $1,000 to let me talk to him on his show for 2 hours to the audience about this without any hangups. I also offered that schmuck MV who is hosting that $500, and Bell would have said yes, but he said, I already did a deal with MV. I said, really? And then MV has the audacity to say, yeah, you don't go try to steal my game. Listen, motherfucker, I didn't call into that show for you, as I told you. I called in for Bell. You have no idea of this case, and you're not even a factor in this case. And me giving you any type of money to have me on, by your disrespect, you could go fuck yourself. Point out, go fuck yourself. You weren't serious about this subject, but you did show me something. You were bought. You were bought so easily, MB. Okay? And how would it be when I'm on there anyway? What? Maybe you got half a dozen listeners? Maybe 100? Maybe 200? Who gives a shit? That ain't enough. I needed to talk to the man himself. He's worth the big bucks. Art, I still want to offer you $1,000. If that's still open, I want that deal with you, not that schmuck MB. He's an asshole. His nose is up your ass. He's not serious researcher. He's not a serious show host. And he's disrespectful to the audience, trying to be somebody he's not. You'll never fill Art Bell's shoes. That's why you didn't get on the Dark Matter Radio Network, you asshole. What are you going to do about it, MB? I dare you. Again, shut me up. Come make me. I dare you. The deal's off for you. No 500 bucks for you, though I'm glad I helped expose how easy you could be bought, punk. Art, $1,000 to you. Now, with that being said, hopefully it's a little clearer and understanding when you hear these clips on where it's going, because this is the recent news. And those following Art Bell in the recent times and the recent things going on, I guarantee you he's trying to cover up and dig out from the flack from what happened to Vic Vara exposing them. They're trying to come up with excuses and the what could have went wrong and what why is this happening, why is that happening? Then dig out. No, they're assholes and their network ain't going to last much longer if I succeed or if I have something to do about it and when the Martian revelation has something to do about it. Yes, like I said, when? Because it's coming back. What you going to do, Hoagland? You're going to pay everybody not to be on my show? Are you that valuable to everybody? All the researchers that they will not be on my radio show for chances to be heard and all that because of you? What are you offering them? Because no matter where you go, a conference or no matter what, sometime, somehow, somewhere, this subject's going to be there. You can't run from it forever and you won't. I promise you. We deserve the truth. We deserve these faces of Mars. But you know what? You deserve whatever else this is going to do to you itself because it's based on your own actions of what you've done and it was seen what was done and they're saying no. Someone don't like it and someone thinks you should be doing something else. So here I am, a game changer, sent down through time to cut you off at the pass down through time. Well, to make sure that your death, whenever and however it happens, the legacy you thought you would leave behind is going to be modeled by this conspiracy of yours. Am I saying something wrong? Prove me wrong. Debate me. I also offered you $1,000, Hoagland, to put me on your show for an hour just to let me speak without hanging up on me and without slandering me. Just to let me speak and show what I needed to show and have you answer a few simple questions only. And $1,000. And you were like, Gary, we're not relitigating this. Really, motherfucker? We haven't begun to litigate it yet. You cannot relitigate something that has not been in litigation yet. And the statute of limitations have not run out, thanks to you and your big mouth talking shit again, slandering me, keeping that train open at least another year and at least, I've been told. It's coming, Rich. You dark missioners should be really worried about and thinking about that. You're frauds, you're fakes, you're greedy son of a bitches, and you're not out for the truth. and you think everyone else is too stupid to see it. They'll just be entertained and be hypnotically pulled in by your Pied Piperness. Well, not with me out here, motherfucker. That's all I got to say. That goes for you too, Art Bell. But I still think there's hope in you. You wanted the dialogue. That MV punk bitch didn't. And he didn't want me on it, spoiling his big moment of sticking his nose up your ass. Prove me wrong. $1,000. The offer still stands to Bell. MV, go fuck yourself. Let's listen.
Hi, you're on the air with Art. Hello?
Welcome to me.
Yeah. Hey, buddy.
How you doing?
I'm great. Thanks for calling.
Great show. And Art, glad to see you back on.
Well, thank you.
You asked a very valid question. What happens after death? What is it, faith? Or is it belief? Or, you know, it's a good analogy you have, looking at it from the perspective of, well, it's either one or, but that's where faith comes in. And that's where hell comes in. And that's why I want to know why you're covering up for Hoagland, helping this conspiracy, and instead of helping me get the truth, I came to you in 2012. Begging you to help me get the truth.
Okay,
no,
caller.
No.
Caller,
no.
We're going to have to... Just let's...
You're complicit to the conspiracy.
Okay.
Just to prove that there are stalkers, he is Hoagland's stalker.
Oh, is he? Okay, caller, if you could just take a breath, we could have a conversation. Do you want to do that, or do you just want to continue? Do you want to have a conversation, or do you just want to yell at us? No? Okay, have a good night. Hi, you're on the air. Hello.
With it, you said this might be reviewed in 20 years. And
yeah, I don't buy that either. Hey there, you're on the air. Hi.
Hello, MV. Great job.
Hey, buddy.
I'm so good to hear you. This is Hawtex.
I'm glad you called.
Over the years, Art, you've seemed to develop a real tight level of trust with people. Now, have you been getting emails from folks wanting you back so they can disclose some information?
I don't know that I understand the question.
Okay, yes. There's been a lot of things revealed on your show.
The answer is yes. There are constantly many, many people who feel they have vital information to get out. And I get a lot of emails like that, so the answer is yes.
Okay, I get it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate the call. See how Art was on top of it, and I was drawing little doodles in my book here. Hi, you're on the air. Hello.
Yes, I'm back. I wasn't aware. I wasn't hung up on. I apologize. And I do like to talk about this calmly, and I thank you for saying that.
Okay, well, there are about to be rude.
I thought you had hung up on me.
No, I was just waiting for you to take a breath, and so in
I appreciate that.
I
apologize to the audience.
And in less than a paragraph, can you explain what your problem is with Art Hoagland at all?
Yes, Art Bell. I've been emailing you since 2012. You know who I am since Outback Coast days when I used to call in with Hoagland. At times, even spoke to you a couple times, and
I know who you are.
Paragraph.
All right, okay. Let's move beyond that. I don't even know who I am. That's the problem here, because a lot of people wanted to know why you're not helping me and help them get all the truth from Hoagland about UFO Diaries, the video he was in. I'm not a stalker, and Art, you know that. He had me as an honorary member at his site for years. He was a member
okay,
of my
all right.
show.
Okay, take a breath.
Take a breath.
Go ahead, Art.
That's what Hoagland calls you, is his stalker. That's why I called you that. Okay?
He wants to call me a stalker, but he's in control of you.
Okay, but why? Hold on. Just a breath for one moment. Yeah. Art is not asserting that you are a stalker, so why are you taking the grievance up with Art?
Yes, he did.
Hoagland calls you his stalker.
Call me a stalker.
Well, I don't know. I do love your accent, though, sir. hi, you're on the air. Hello.
Hey, Art. It's great to hear your voice.
Hi, you're on the air.
Yeah, so I'd like to try for step three without being hung up this time. Can I give my paragraph, or can I just make a comment?
Again, stop for a minute. I said that you were what Hoagland calls his stalker, and that is you. And the question is why you keep coming at him the way you do, and you're doing it here tonight. So slow down.
Can I give my response?
Give us what your gripe really is.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead.
Okay. Thank you.
Paragraph.
Now, Art.
You're not going to give a speech. Give it in a paragraph. I. No one has time for this.
All right. But, Art, this would be a show between me and you because you need the story. But anyway, to get the facts, then you'll know the facts. And then everyone else will, too. Hoagland calls me a stalker. I'm not. Scorsese encouraged an investigation in 2006 into a video.
Sir, I don't even know who you are. I don't have time for this. No. Hi, you're on the air. I don't even know who you are, so why would I care who called you a stalker or whether you actually are or not? Nobody cares. Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, yeah, this is not the stalker. I think you'll be happy.
Thank you.
Hey, Art and Mike. Interesting. I like the show tonight. Thanks for coming back, Art, and talking to your fans, the guys that have been so loyal since the 90s to you. Art, I do want to thank you for The Other Side of Midnight. I actually really enjoy that show. Is there any chance that Hoagland might come on a little earlier?
No, I don't think so. And while I'm at it, let me straighten something out with regard to something Richard's been saying. Richard's been saying, I'm sure you know since you're a listener, that he's carrying the network, right?
Go ahead. He's gone.
He's gone.
Yeah, he's gone. Go ahead.
Richard has been saying he's been carrying the network on a regular basis. And to be clear, Heather is carrying the network. By a long shot, Heather is carrying the network.
And you mean that specifically in terms of subscriber metrics?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's a rather an unambiguous way of measuring, I would have to say.
And the way that translates into dollars in every way you can imagine.
Yeah. I think people who are not surrounded by... We sometimes forget that... We as bell gabbers and, I can just simplify with that. As bell gabbers, we're living inside of a bubble here that we sometimes are unaware of. And there are going to be plenty of people who hear Heather who aren't attached to the emotion of all of this.
Yeah.
And will make objective judgments. I can't talk. Hey, you're on with Art Bell.
Hello.
Yes, why do you keep hanging up on me?
Because you're like,
you're like
the audio form of throat cancer. You have no social sensibility whatsoever.
Whatever you say, that's slander, but let me give my paragraph.
No, it would be slander.
Art, you're afraid of controversy, aren't you? You're afraid of controversy on your show because you don't want them to look at UFO Diaries or Hoagland's Connection or Art Bell's.
Listen, do you have a website? Do you have a website that you would like to plug where people can read your perspective?
How about this? Let me be a guest on your show for 2 hours.
Mine?
I'll pay you $500.
Mine or Art's?
Either or. Art, I'll give you $1,000.
If you pay me $500, you can be a guest on the Gabcast.
You got it. And you let me present my story.
I will.
$1,000.
You will have total carte blanche.
Michael has just made a deal with
Well, yeah. I mean, I don't really necessarily want Art to step in on my business here.
Right.
Hey, no offense. I called him because Art's on to confront him, but I'm more than willing to let you and your audience know. I thought you were being cool with me, but then you're being complicit, too. Now you're being cool again for $500. So be it. I bought you. Art, $1,000 to join us? To join us? Or let me be on with you also? You have a lot of great points.
Okay, slow down a second. You know, one thing that I'd like to understand is, what part I even play in this? Your gripe is with Richard, not me.
It's not. Not only you. Can I answer? I know what you're saying. What is my gripe with you? How about this? You allowing Hoagland to control Mike Farris' show, his network, to get my archives off of it because it points to Hoagland, and what? You.
Why do you assume Art is controlling Hoagland?
Because
yeah, you didn't really have a good answer to that one, did you? Maybe you should.
I do. I've got a good answer.
Okay.
I have zero financial interest or anything with the network at all. I have no official position with the network right now. I make not one penny from the network right now. All I'm doing is trying to help out Heather and giving her advice. That's it.
Hey, you're on with Art Bell. Hi.
Pardon me?
You're on with Art Bell. Hey, you're on with Art Bell. Hi.
Yeah, Michael, I was just wondering if the Richard Stalker was still on the line. I'd like to offer him $250 to appear on the Bell Files Sunday evening. SteepTalkRadio.com. Hi, Art. Hi, MV.
Hey, buddy. How's it going, Jazzy?
I'm good, thank you.
And I'm getting on there, and I'm just annoying all of these people. This is going to be a legendary broadcast that people refer to for years to come. I'm happy to have been a part of it. I'm thrilled at the number of people who listened live tonight. Hey, we got somebody else on here. Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, why do you hang up on me? That's what you said, yes. Do you want the money to let me tell my story?
Well, you know, you have to understand the context in which you're calling. I mean,
I know the context. You don't.
Apparently, I don't know. I get the kind of the feeling
you're
you
right.
don't.
You don't know. Yeah, I know the context. How do you know? Do you know about this case?
Okay, here's
and
the
context.
Let me inform you of the context. You're calling in to a radio show.
Yep.
On which Art Bell is a guest with a personal with a personal grievance which requires
more than personal. You should be offended too.
I don't care really, but I mean you're calling
you don't
in
care, you don't care.
Are you going to Hey, can you shut your face and let me say something and then I'll let
if
you
we
speak.
Were in person, you wouldn't
are you
going like
to are
go
you
ahead.
Are you going to let me speak or do you just want to continue, you know?
Go
I mean
ahead,
it requires
me
you know, well, you'll get to, but I mean it requires
okay,
a bi-directional dialogue in order for that to work.
Right.
Otherwise
gotcha.
It's just a mess of audio. You know what I'm saying?
I know. I used to be a radio show host, so don't
Oh my god, that must have been a listen. What time did you surely you did that at 4 a.m. starting? I mean that I would imagine that kept the people
surely
awake, right?
You're doing bad at debunking me, but go ahead, make your point.
Okay, I'll speed up for you. I see that you don't like it when people take a long time to get to the point. That's ironic at best, but I'll make my point. You need to understand the context. Are you going to shut the fuck up, or are you going to let me talk?
Hey, dude, I'm listening. You're talk big, but go ahead.
Okay, this, Bucky. Hey, this is Frank Rizzo! Do you understand that reference? You sound exactly like Frank Rizzo. Hey there, jerky. So he's up there on the roof with the hot mops. He's slapping around like he knows which way is up. I fired him under the floor.
So personal attack is what you want to say.
No, I'm quoting the jerky boys. You're not a very fun person, are you?
Hey, dude, How about answer? Do you want to know the story? $500. When can I come on?
Oh, you can come on the Gabcast anytime. I'll have you on for 2 hours. Just send, go to Bellgab, click on the donate button, submit a $500 payment. You will be on the next Gabcast for 2 hours.
I want you to say that live on the air.
You're on the air right now. You're on the air. I told you as soon as I picked up the phone with you that you're on the air.
I didn't know that.
Oh, you are.
I hung up. I thought the show was over, okay? Your show
is
not that familiar to me.
It is over, but we are still on the air, yes.
All right, great. So, are you done or insulting, or can I go on?
When did I insult you? I said you're not a very fun person. I quote the Jerky Boys, and you start bleeding from the vag.
Whatever you say, all right.
That is what I say.
What I was trying to bring up.
What I was trying to explain to you is the context into which you are calling tonight, and the context is that of a radio show on which Art Bell is currently a guest. You have to think about the listening audience. I understand your own personal desire to impart upon people this information they must know, but do you understand from just a listenability perspective, for that of the audience, what you were bringing to the show tonight just wasn't going to work? Can you at least give me that?
Really? Wow, that's not what I seen in the Bellgap chat. Wow. You know, I don't know what you're reading, buddy, but they're real interested in this.
Okay, great. I don't care. A lot of them have no idea what makes for good radio then, if that's what they think.
Now, you just said it's about the audience. Now, you don't care about the audience, what they think or feel.
No, my instincts tell me that what you were bringing to the show tonight was pretty hard to listen to. Yeah.
Oh, that's because you haven't heard about it. It's been covered up.
No, it's just your presentation. You might be totally legit in everything you have to say. It's just that you sound like you're on really heavy doses of ADD medication. Huh?
Here's the thing. It's another attack. Whatever. Well, you're not that smart. But anyway, I got evidence to back up my stuff. I got evidence, you see? That's the thing that makes a story more credible is when there's evidence.
Evidence of what? I mean, why is Art Bell the person to take your grievance to? I don't get it.
Because he's deceiving the networks for their money so he could control the
networks. Deceiving what networks?
Here I am again.
Deceiving what networks?
The radio shows that was a part of Dark Matter Radio Network. He deceived them all. To create a network where he did not have to really work but make a cut while giving control of the ship, wink, wink, to Hoagland, who was in control of the Dark Mission. Dark Mission, Dark Matter. It's not a coincidence.
Yeah, hold on just a minute. We have another caller on the line. Go ahead.
Michael, you know, I'm a doc, ER doc, and this caller that you have is clearly psychotic. I mean this in the most...
Right. I'm psychotic. What evidence do you base your stuff off of? Shut up, you quack. This ain't for you. This ain't for you. This guy is the one that's going to get paid to bring you the truth.
Well out of control. I recommend 5 milligrams Haldol. I am stat... If he was in my
I recommend you go sit on a corn, dude.
Jerky.
Go sit on a piece of corn.
Doctor, if this man walked into your office sounding the way he sounds at this moment, what would your response be?
Well, I don't have an office.
How about this? Stop avoiding it. Hey, why are you guys avoiding the issue? Why are you guys avoiding
I'm not avoiding it. I'm not avoiding it. I'm agreeing to allow you to be on an entire... I am agreeing to allow you to be on an entire episode of the Gabcast.
What we do is we sedate them with 5 milligrams of an anti-strong...
I dare you. Come try, motherfucker. Come try to sedate my ass. I dare you. Come on.
We heard you. You don't have to repeat the phrase, I dare you. That's what people do on Maury.
Did you know he had Dr. Robin pretend to be my doctor and tried to have me committed?
Oh, that's a shame.
Do you know that? And she's not even a doctor. She's not a doctor. She's not a doctor. She tried to have me committed because Hoagland wanted to shut me up. This is when he made me homeless and tried to have me committed when he destroyed my show. He destroyed my show, The Martian Revelation, because of an investigation he encouraged that led back to him, and he punishes me because of what the producers, the main, the main testifiers that said Hoagland provided what he provided, which is what this is all about. Faces of Mars, the public's never known about, but it's secret intelligence data that Hoagland has control of, and he's not allowed to acknowledge it.
Okay, so here's what we'll do.
Hold on. In fact, he does everything.
Okay, I just don't want...
I
just don't want you to blow your wad here before your actual Gabcast appearance. That's all.
Oh, no, no. I'm just laying some ground seeds. You have no idea who I am, but you better do some research, buddy, especially to earn the money I'm going to be giving you.
Well, you present me. You present
you
me.
You
are you going
to...
How do you present me with the research material? Present me with the research material. I don't know who you are. I don't know anything about you. It's not my job to find out about you.
It's not. But yeah, you want to control the flow what your listeners get to hear, right?
Well, I mean, I have all these knobs.
That doesn't... Now you have knowledge. But yeah, you have no knowledge of that.
Okay. Well, that's... I mean, you can only take a limited amount of that, you know?
Little bit of paranoid ideation coming out there, to say the least, with a tremendous amount of... I guess we'd call it, in doctor parlance, total craziness.
That would be the clinical term, then.
You know, I'm an emergency room doc, so that's I get to see all sorts of things. But he's clearly, by any stretch of the imagination, psychotic, and floridly psychotic. And I don't know how dangerous he would be, but you know, obviously he needs help.
I think, to say the least. Well, I would love to receive his $500 payment. I will put him on the Gabcast. Think of all the diapers I can buy with that money. That's what I would like to impart upon you. So I hope everybody enjoyed the show tonight. This is not the show. This is just me goofing around here for a couple of seconds. You come to realize just how we've all been screwed as consumers for the last 10 years, and we're really just not getting the audio experience we should be getting out of the equipment that we use that's become mainstream.